Hi students, today we can start introduction of exercise 10.5. In this introduction, we'll study scalar triple product. Scalar triple product. Then, what is scalar triple product? If you consider three different vectors, let A vector, B vector and C vector. Three vectors. The scalar triple product, STP, scalar triple product is scalar product of A vector and B vector cross C vector. Scalar product already you have studied, isn't it? Dot product. Then scalar product of A vector and B cross C is known as scalar triple product. You can write A vector dot B cross C. This is known as scalar triple product. Then, this scalar triple product we can write. It can be write. Use square bracket. A vector, B vector, vector. Using by commas we can write, otherwise without comma also we can write A vector, B vector, C. This like also we can write scalar triple product. Then what is scalar triple product? First we can see the meaning. Anyway, when you take scalar product, you will get one scalar quantity only. Already you know, one number only you will get. In here also, after doing this part, you will get one scalar quantity only. Now we can see some observations. Observations. Observations meaning properties. Some properties of scalar triple product. First property is scalar triple product is a scalar quantity. You will get answer one scalar number only. Then second observation is, if you consider geometrically, the scalar triple product is volume of parallelepiped. What do you mean by this parallelepiped? If you consider one parallelogram. Okay, we can consider first one parallelogram. This parallelogram. This downside is B vector. This one is C vector. This direction and here also this direction. Then this parallelogram, you know, if you consider the height also. This is height. Then we can make one parallelepiped. This like. This vector is A vector. You can see in here three vectors from this corner, first A vector, B vector and C vector. Then this figure is known as parallelepiped. Scalar triple product is volume of parallelepiped. How to find out volume of this figure? Volume means height into base area. That is known as volume, isn't it? Then directly we cannot find out volume from here. Then if you find out B cross C, the direction of B cross C from this corner, this is B vector, this is C vector. If you make one perpendicular, this is the direction of B cross C. Then we need height, means up to here from this top side, we consider up to here. This is height of this parallelepiped. Then how to find out height? Height means you can see in here this part. This part is known as projection of A vector, isn't it? That means height we can write projection of A vector on which vector? On B cross C vector. That is height of this figure into base area. Base area means modulus of this B cross C. Already you have studied what is the area of parallelogram. How to find out B cross C? This is like one formula studied, is it? B and C, the adjacent sides of parallelogram. In previous exercise, you have studied area of parallelogram is magnitude of B cross C. Otherwise, there A cross B. B and C should be adjacent side of parallelogram. That time we will get base area. Now, projection of A vector. Projection means A vector dot B cross C divided by magnitude of B vector cross C vector. This part is known as projection. This part also we have studied. Then projection of A vector on B vector equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of B vector. This is like one formula I have studied, isn't it? But in here, we cannot use B vector on which vector? B cross C, isn't it? Then, into this last part, magnitude of B cross C, correct? I will get A vector dot B cross C. This is the area of parallelepiped. Then, what is this? This is scalar triple product. Already you know this formula, isn't it? Now you have studied. Third observation is, how to find out scalar triple product? Then, if we consider three vectors, A vector is A1i, A2j, A3k. Then B vector, second vector is B1i, B2j, B3k. Third vector, C vector, C1i, C2j, C3k. We'll consider three vectors. Then scalar triple product, that is A vector, B vector, C vector. Isn't it? This one we can write A vector dot B cross C. Now we can find out B cross C. B cross C equal to, we will use a determinant method. In first row we can write I, J, K. In second row, what you will write? The scalar component of B and C. B vector, isn't it? B1, B2, B3. Then C vector means, in here you can see it is C1, C2, C3. Find out determinant, that is I vector into, leave it first column, first row, then remaining B2, B3, C2, C3. Just take cross multiple B2 into C3. then common minus C2 into B3. Then starting plus, then minus, isn't it? Minus J vector. We can leave first row and second column. Then remaining B1, B3, C1, C3, isn't it? Then take cross multiple B1 into C3 minus C1 into B3 plus K vector, last vector. Just to leave it. Then B1, B2, C1, C2 remaining. Take cross multiple B1 into C2 minus C1 into B2. Now we can take A vector dot B cross C equal to, let's write A vector. A vector is A1i, A2j, A3k. This A vector B cross C already is there. We got it. We can write that I B2 C3 C2 B3 minus J B1 C3 C1 B3 plus K vector B1 C2 C1 B2. Now take dot product. How to take dot product? We will multiple similar term. In here I term, in here also I term, only we can multiple. Then A1, this part, B2 C3 minus C2 B3. First I and I will be 1. Then A1 on the remaining part. Then minus J. Minus J means minus A2. J into J. J dot J1, isn't it? Then A2 we can write in here, A2. Then B1, C3, C1, B3. Then K term. K dot K will be 1, isn't it? Then A3 is there. In here, B1, C2, C1, B2. We got, what is this? This one we can write in determinant form. That is A1, A2, A3. Then B1, B2, B3. C1, C2, C3. Check it. Possible or not? Look in here. This part. This part. I, J, K. The place of I, J, K. What we have written? A1, A2, A3. Then remaining part is same only. Isn't it? The place of I, J, K, we are written A1, A2, A3. Then in here also what we can write? A1, A2, A3. A1, A2, A3. Then remaining part is same. Then this is our scalar triple product. If they are given three vectors, directly we can use this determinant. All the scalar components we will use in here. Then take determinant, you will get scalar triple product. Okay. This is our third observation. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook this part also. Because always you will use in here this formula. Not only in this chapter, next chapter, that is three-dimensional geometry also we will use same formulas. Now we can see fourth observation, that is cyclic permutation of three vectors does not change the value of scalar triple product. What is cycle permutation? If you consider is A vector, then B vector, C vector. Cycle means clockwise rotation, isn't it? It's rotation. Then A vector, B vector, C vector. These are our scalar triple product. Then we start from here, A vector. Then start from B vector. B vector. And then next will be C vector. As will be A vector. Equal to, again start from C vector. C vector, then A vector, then last B vector. First we use A, A, B, C. The next B, C, A. Last we start from C. C, A, B. This is known as cyclic permutation. Then if you change this like, the value of scalar triple product will not change. Now we can see this part also. You know, already now we have studied A, B, C. Scalar triple product of A, B, C. We can write A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. A means, A vector means, like before, A1, I plus A2, J plus A3, K. Then B vector is B1, I plus B2, J plus C2, B3, K. Like that. C vector all of similarly. Then, scalar triple product of A vector, B vector, C vector we can write in this form. Isn't it? Now, we can see this part. Check it in here. B, C, A. Isn't it? First, we can change this first row and third row. Interchange that one. That time, and we can write C1, C2, C3. Then B1, B2, B3. Then A1, A2, A3. We interchange first row and third row. This two. We interchange that one. Okay. Then when you interchange two rows, what you will write? We have to write one minus. Then only we can interchange two rows or two columns. Now, we can interchange first row and second row. What you will get? First and second. These two just interchange again. Already minus is there. Then, when you interchange these two, we have to write one more minus. Isn't it? Then write B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Then last row as it is A1, A2, A3. And here R1 and R2 we interchange. Minus and minus you will get plus. Isn't it? Getting here plus. What is this? This one we can write B vector, then C vector, then A vector. Second one. Isn't it? Then, we start from triple product of A vector, B vector, C vector. We got scalar triple product of B, C, A. Second part. This one also we can make same like that. Next observation. In scalar triple product, that is A dot, B dot, C. Can be interchange a dot and post. In here you can see one dot, in here you can see one dot that we can interchange. That means A dot B cross C. This one we can write A cross B dot C. We are interchange that two. A dot and cross. Then this will not change. This answer is same only. We can see that A dot B cross C. This means A B C. Isn't it? Then this one we can write using by previous observation, that is cyclic permutation. It's like cyclic permutation, if you are using start from B, that is B then C A. C A. Equal to again C A B. C A B. If you write last part, what do you get? C dot A cross B. You know, a dot product is commutative. That means A dot B, we can write B dot A also. That is commutative only, isn't it? Same method we can apply in here. That is A cross B vector dot C vector. Because we can interchange this one. The dot product is commutative. Check it now. Our answer. This is our answer. Isn't it? Keep in mind this part how we are written. That is checking by previous observation. Cycle permutation does not change the scale after triple product. Okay. Using by that observation, we can make another one. We can interchange dot and cross of scale after triple product. You will get same answer only. Next observation is A, B, C equal to minus A, C, B. Okay. In here, A, same only, but B and C, in here C and B, I interchange. This is not cycle permutation. Okay, then we'll get, we have to use one negative. If you interchange only two vectors, how can you do that? In here, A, B, C, we can write A dot B cross C. These are A, B, C equal to, now A dot, if you interchange, in the case of cross product, we can write C cross B. Why we are using in here one minus means, you know, cross product is not commutative. A cross B, we can write minus B cross A. When you interchange the position of vectors in the case of cross product, you have to write one minus in the case of cross product. Same method I use in here. B cross C, I written C cross B, that time what we have to use? One minus we have to use, isn't it? Then this minus write first, minus A vector dot C cross B. This one we can write minus A C B. This is our right side. Then, seventh observation, A, A, B, equal to 0. In scalar triple product, if you consider two vectors are same, A vector, you will get answer is 0. What is the reason? In here, if you write this one, the form of determinant, A1, A2, A3, again A1, A2, A3, because two times repeated A vector, then B1, B2, D3. In any determinant, two rows are equal means what will get answer? We will get answer 0. Already you know, isn't it? In chapter 4, determinants already you have studied. In any determinant, two rows or two columns are equal means our answer will be 0. The scalar triple product of A, A, B will be 0. Then, similarly, other things also we can write A, B, B. This like also. If you write, you will get answer 0. The last, coplanarity of three vectors. If A vector, B vector, C vector are coplanar, then A vector dot B cross C equal to so. If you consider three vectors in a plane, A vector, B vector, C vector, when you take scalar triple product, you will get answer 0. Whatever reason means, the volume of a plane we cannot find out. No volume, isn't it? Only one plane, isn't it? No volume, so the answer will be 0. Now we can see example number 26. Find A dot B cross C if A vector equal to 2i plus j plus 3k, B vector equal to minus I plus 2j plus k. You have to write in here one minus in your textbook, that is plus only. Have to consider as minus I. The next, C vector equal to 3i plus j plus 2k. You can find out scalar triple product, that is A vector dot B cross C. How to find out? We will use a determinant method. Determinant of 2, 1, 3. Then there minus 1, 2, 1. Here 3, 1, 2. First plus, then minus, then plus. 2 into, you can leave first column, first row, then remaining 2 into 2, 4, minus 1 into 1, 1, then minus 1. Then first row, second column, minus 1 into 2, minus 2, then minus 3 into 1, 3, then plus 3, it is. Minus 1 into 1, minus 1, then minus 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 4 minus 1, 3, minus 1 into in here minus 5. Plus 3 into last part is minus 7. 6 plus in here minus into minus plus 1 into 5, 5 minus 21 equal to 6 plus 5, 11 minus 21 is minus 10. This is our scalar triple product. Just for the video, write down in your notebook this example also. Now we can see example number 27. Show that vectors A vector equal to I minus 2j plus 3k, B vector equal to minus 2i plus 3j minus 4k. In your textbook, they give one plus 2i, change as minus 2i. And C vector equal to I minus 3j plus 5k are coplanar. How to prove three vectors are coplanar? When you take scalar triple product, if you are getting answer 0 means we can say that three vectors are coplanar. Now we can take scalar triple product equal to determinant of 1 minus 2, 3, there minus 2, 3, minus 4, and here 1, minus 3, 5. In here plus, minus, plus, isn't it? 1 into, you can leave first column, first row, then 3 into 5, 15, minus, minus 3 into minus 4 is plus 12. Here minus, minus into minus plus, we can write 2, plus 2. Common minus will come, plus, minus, plus, then minus 2 minus are there, minus into minus, plus, we can write plus 2. Leave it second column, first row. Minus 2 into 5, minus 10. 1 into minus 4. Common minus we can write. 1 into minus 4, minus 4. The last. Plus 3. Into leave it to third column on first row. 6. Minus 1 into 3. 3. Equal to 1 into in here 3, 15 minus 12, 3, plus 2 into in here plus 4, minus 10 plus 4 is minus 6, plus 3 into 6 minus 3 is 3, we'll do 3 minus 12 plus 9, we can do 0. We got answer is 0, therefore A vector, B vector and C vector are coplanar. This is our answer. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Then in next video we can do exercise 10.5, remaining examples also similar questions only. When you do exercise 10.5, you can understand more.